Well, my dear friends, yes, we are back revisiting the lost artist colony, but it's very sad today. It is indeed breaking news. Dieter's beautiful little castle atelier that he had built from hand has sadly burnt to the ground. Unbelievable that I just visited only a few months back. It's been around for so long, I just couldn't believe it when I read it on the news here, the local news. I actually did see the firemen congregating round, not knowing what it was about, until I read about it later. Absolutely devastated. Oh, my goodness. Let's hope Dieter has a different point of view in the afterlife about things. Yeah, about inevitability of the eventual destruction of everything on Earth. But it's very sad, really, after all the work that he put in. Unbelievable. Look at that. Now, it took the firemen so long to get here. Not only that, there's no running water. Here we're going to see some footage soon of the actual fire at the time. There was no running water. There is no running water here, so the firemen had to unroll the hose by hand all the way up the hill into the colony. And by that stage, the place was gutted. Well and truly gutted, you can see. Yeah, unbelievable. You think, you know, stone, solid, should be almost indestructible, but it's not. No. And, you know, the mortar gets loosened, weakened. It expands and breaks away. One of Dieter's mutual friends was here at the site when I visited, and he told me they're going to try and rebuild it if they can get the funds. I mean, these guys are all poor. Dieter's sister's got no money to spend on this either. He's saying that the parts that will be rebuilt will be only rebuilt in wood, not in stone. It's a real shame. You can see here, it's just all the rubble. Apparently, the woman that was using this place that I mentioned in the first video, if you haven't watched the first video, I'll leave the link in the description. She had some sort of heating. It was either kerosene or petrol, and I don't know whether it was an accident or negligence. I wouldn't like to say. But that's what started the fire. She managed to get out, luckily. And this is what is left. You're now getting to see inside the atelier. You didn't get the opportunity last time because it was locked, but what tragic circumstances. This is the iron wood-burning heater that Dieter had installed, and yeah. A good solid safe heater. We would sit there and have beers in winter. That was his upper storage where he slept. Yeah, he had the wood heater, which was safe, I say again. She didn't use that for some reason. Maybe it was too much hard work. But terrible. Terrible. Yeah, no more cups of tea. No more water boiled in that, Dieter. Luckily, this part seems to have escaped relatively unscathed. Yeah, thank goodness some of the stuff is still left intact. This is all Dieter's work. We would sit here in summer in this part and have a few cold beers. And a little smoke. That was the model of the house that he built out of wood. That was the model out of the house that I told you about in the last video. If you haven't seen it, do watch it. I hadn't seen this model in years. I didn't realize it was tucked away inside here. Little fountain there. Oh my goodness, Dieter. Ooh, he'll be shaking his fist, I tell you. He'd be shaking his fist. Not at me, but whoever was the cause of this fire. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that. I love that design. Isn't that fantastic? And more stones for the house construction, all made by hand. All made by hand. Wow. I'm just so glad I can document this, even in this state, and the documentation that I did before. And I even have earlier photographs from about 10 years back. I think this is something amazing for Switzerland. They haven't caught on yet. They really haven't caught on. There's no funding for his work. This stuff should be, you know, classed as national heritage, really should. One day they may wake up to it. Yeah, local council here, no help whatsoever. I won't say too much, I might get sued. No financial help. So I'm gonna, yeah, the translation here is on there for you. This is a note left by Dieter's sister. Wow. Der Trümmer. Yeah, look at this beautiful wheel. I mean, see, that'd be weakened now. All the mortar would have, you know, weakened by the fire. You can see the cracks going right through it now. I'm worried. Dieter's friend outside there said they were going to fix it, and I said, oh, well, I'll check in 6 months. I'm not holding my breath, though. I told him that, too. I do hope this gets fixed. I really do. All the wooden shutters burnt out. The flooring, the beautiful oak flooring that he had in there. A crying shame, my dear Oddites. A crying shame. Out of any building in this colony, it had to be that one. Things that make you go, like the Notre Dame. Won't say too much on that either. Anyway, I will keep you posted over the years to come on what develops or not develops. Oh, look, there's the fountain again. You remember it was frozen when I visited last time? It's not frozen anymore. The heat from the fire well and truly melted it. This is another part of the colony you didn't see last time. A lot of old cars here. Unregistered cars. I think there are people living in this part. I ventured up a bit further, but then I did hear music, so it seems to be possibly occupied, unless they've left a radio one from years ago. up this part there is one house from the 1800s, and maybe one day I'll get a closer view from the other side. That was originally built by a barber for the stone quarry who lived in the 1800s, and he did so well from the stone quarry men who were working there, he had the house built, and it's the only house there with electricity in it. And years ago, a friend of mine, she was running this as a type of open-air bistro, and she lived in that house, had a beautiful underground cavern where we'd had fondue evenings. Schnapps fondue evenings. It was brilliant in winter. And now it's just an absolute wasteland, yeah. And her ex-husband did all these sculptures up here. He's no longer here either. He's still alive, but he's no longer here. Yeah, see the nice old wagon there? I mean, not a bad place to camp out. Yeah, so up here is where I heard the music. Seems to be almost like a sort of Romany style camp there with the old wagon. I was just hoping no wild dog came bouncing towards me. Yeah, a lot better than living in a train station, isn't it? This is the place to be, winter or summer. Yeah, if you're going to be homeless, then why not here? Well, my cat has just come through the door announcing that it's her dinner time, or ordering me to cease working, and she must be obeyed. But before I go, do you remember that demonic house that my friend visited and fell over, his hair stood on end and he flew out of there? Well, about 2 days later, he gave me a gift. And I didn't connect it to the house. I didn't connect it at all, but then it sort of came into my head about a day or two later. And then I said to him, "Where did you get that beautiful old radiogram from?" He said, "Oh, it's from that creepy demonic house." And I said, "Well, thanks a lot." He said, "What? No, the radio is not a problem." Anyway, I don't think it is, so I've put it in my lockup. I have a lockup not far from where I live. And this radio had an old plug on, the type that has not been used in Switzerland in decades. So it obviously hasn't been used in decades. I just changed the plug and wow, it just sprung to life after the valves warmed up. Well, like new. I haven't had to do anything to it. Just plug it in. It's in my lockup and gives a wonderful sound. I'll let you listen to it. Here it is now. Anyway, I will take the opportunity to say goodbye, my friends, and I'll be back soon. Take care and have a great weekend.